You're doing sports regularly, you eat healthy, and still you're not quite happy with your results. Today we will talk about one of the most underestimated factors when it comes to physical performance and muscle growth. And that is stress. Let's have a closer look. First, I want to show you a paper published in Sports Medicine, which basically reviewed 168 studies which examined the influence on stress on physical activity. Without going too much into details, almost all data suggest a negative correlation between stress and sport. From not even wanting to do sports, to a weaker performance during the physical activity, to less muscle protein synthesis afterwards. So, what exactly is happening? And how and why is the stress hormone cortisol in this context so important and powerful? First of all, I want to make clear what I mean when we talk about stress. Well, stress in a physiological sense can mean that I exaggerate during my pull-up session or, I don't know, a dumbbell falls on my foot. But there are also different types of psychological stress, from acute to chronic to even traumatic stress. And all these different types of stress release a key hormone, we all heard about it, cortisol. Cortisol is a steroid hormone which is produced in the adrenal glands, that are these weird things on top of the kidneys. And it regulates your body's response to stress, or what you think a stressful stimuli is. I mean, that's obviously a very subjective thing. And after cortisol is released, it binds to so-called glucocorticoid receptors, and these are expressed on almost all tissues in our bodies. And this is why stress affects your whole body. I actually made a video about how chronic stress influences your whole organism, so check it out if you're interested. Let me make one thing 100% clear. Acute stress or short-term cortisol peaks are not killing your gains. In fact, it makes us get up in the morning, it is released during exercises, and it's even beneficial, especially in combination with other hormones like, for example, adrenaline. Like this, the metabolism gets activated, the blood pressure and blood sugar levels rise, and so on. But the one thing which definitely is killing your gains is stress on a long term. We have different types of hormones. We have anabolic and catabolic ones. Anabolic ones like testosterone build up tissue using energy, while catabolic ones do the opposite. Guess in which category cortisol belongs to. You know, anabolic and catabolic hormones are usually in a natural balance, and it's extremely important that we have these catabolic ones as well. The breakdown of tissue is obviously a necessity. During chronic stress, though, we constantly have elevated levels of cortisol, and this obviously impairs and hinders muscle protein synthesis and buildup of tissue all the time. And if you don't keep up anabolism during this time, you will 200% lose muscle mass. That is the direct effect of cortisol on our cells. Other effects are increased blood sugar levels and blood pressure. This actually influences you before the workout rather than during the workout. Why? Because one of the most common symptoms of these increases is a constant feeling of tiredness and exhaustion. How motivated are you to give 120% if you can't even motivate you to do breakfast? Simultaneously, high cortisol levels are correlating with a weaker immune system. It's a rather complicated process. It's because of an impairment of the HPA axis due to cortisol resistance, but let's don't go deeper into that. What I want to say is, you can get sick easier. As muscle protein synthesis happens mainly during night, because the testosterone levels are also peaking during night, cortisol not only kind of annihilates its effect, it also reduces the time of quality sleep, as cortisol plays a big role in the sleep-wake cycle. Furthermore, as you need nutrients to build up muscle mass, cortisol also impairs a normal digestive function. With high cortisol levels, your body is constantly in fight or flight mode. That means blood preferably flows into your brain and your extremities like arms and legs so that you can, I don't know, run faster. And less blood is circulating through your digestive system. That also leads to some other problems. Constantly being in this fight or flight mode also has another negative effect. This higher blood circulation in the muscle tissue and muscle cells can lead to a reflex reaction of the body known as a higher muscle tension. That's also a pretty complicated mechanism, but the function is to protect our bodies from pain and injuries. This can be a never-ending circle, and unfortunately for many people it is. So basically, stress leads to muscle tension leads to a worse uptake of nutrients by the muscle cells, this leads to inflammations leads to impaired movement leads to pain, and pain leads to stress. And here we go again. As you can see, high stress and cortisol levels on a long term are killing your gains and your physical performance. It just happens behind the scenes. So if you want to do yourself a favor and get the most out of your workouts, and you're constantly feeling overwhelmed and stressed, you have to work on reducing your stress level. Get enough sleep, don't overtrain, work on your to-do list and stop procrastinating, take time for yourself and spend less time on your phone. There are 5 things which I worked on and I'm still working on, and they helped me a lot, and maybe they will help you as well. Your body will thank you and your performance will increase, guaranteed. And that's already it, guys. Thanks a lot for watching, and I would very much appreciate it if you would subscribe if you haven't already. Stay tuned, stay healthy, and see you next time.